Hey everyone, Jason Shepard here of M08.com. I'm on the left downwind right now for runway 23 at the Williston Airport. And I want to share with you three tips, three secrets to better, or let's call them perfect, short field landings. First things first, I want to start my descent. This isn't one of the tips, this is just a fact. I want to start my descent and beam my touchdown point. I'm aiming for the beginning of the second centerline stripe. Carb heat. Power comes back, 10 degrees of flaps. I always do it in that order. If you go flaps first, where does that nose want to go? I'm already at a disadvantage. You all know I talk about the secret to perfect landings. One of those secrets is a perfect traffic pattern. I want to do that. I want to make sure I've established a descent. Your first tip comes here. You've heard me say the phrase that airspeed is king. I need you to manage your airspeed through this. Now, I don't want you to be really dragging this airplane in here. Remember what we practice when we do a short field landing. Make a radio call real quick. Hey, Williston traffic, Skyhawk 23, Mike Zulu's turn left base, 23, full stop, Williston. I don't want you dragging it in. A real short field takeoff, we're pretending we're clearing an obstacle and we're hitting our point. Well, if you're just dragging it in, trying to hit a point, you're doing a spot landing. You're not doing an appropriate short field landing here. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to demonstrate that here for you. Coming in, again, like I'm clearing an obstacle. I want to manage my airspeed is the big point. I was 90 on downwind. I'm 80 on base. I'm adding my next notch of flaps. I don't like to add flaps in a turn. You've been following me long enough. You guys know that, right? And I'm out here on base and I'm slow. And I want to slow to about 70 on final. And I want to bring this thing in, clearing my obstacle and landing at the beginning of the first centerline stripe is the point that I chose. Final looks clear.
500.
And Williston traffic, Skyhawk 23, Mike Zulu's turn, final runway 23, full stop, Williston. Making a nice, smooth turn to final, already slowing down to my 70. I've got my airspeed managed. Here's your next tip. Your next tip is to aim ahead of your point. You should know your airplane by now and know how well it floats. Hey, a 172 floats a lot further than, say, a Piper Arrow does, right? You should know your airplane and know how well it floats. I'm adjusting my power. I pitch for airspeed. I power for altitude. I'm 68, 67 right now. Speed's great. In the right seat, I'm putting the center line on my chest. If you're sitting in the left seat as a student, you want to go ahead and put that on your right shoulder. I got center line down pat. And my third tip is going to come after touchdown, and it's something called aerodynamic braking, which will be a little discussion here in just a bit. We're coming on in. I'm aiming ahead of my point, like I told you in my second tip here. So I'm really aiming at the beginning of the first centerline stripe, as crazy as that sounds here, but I know the airplane's going to float. So let's say I'm clearing my obstacle. I'm over my imaginary 50-foot obstacle. Now I can really start to bring that airplane on down without picking up airspeed. I can do that by adjusting my power. And what you're not seeing is I'm taking out millimeters of throttle just to bring it back slowly but surely. Aiming ahead of my point, aiming ahead of my point. Here it comes. There goes my aim point. Here comes my touchdown point right there. Just like that. Aerodynamic braking, back on the yoke, on the brakes, and in some cases, flaps up to make it as realistic as possible. Now, I say in some cases. I say in some cases because some check ride examiners, especially in complex airplanes, don't like the idea of you going and touching the flaps, because there was an instance where a student thought he was bringing the flaps up and hit the landing gear switch instead. That makes for a bad day. So a lot of check ride examiners don't want to see that. They want you to simulate aerodynamic braking. Back on the yoke, and I'd be bringing the flaps up now, sir or ma'am, is all you would actually say here. I did it for real this time. Back on the yoke, flaps up. What I'm doing is I'm adding the weight back to those main wheels. And Williston traffic, 23 Mike Zulu's clear of 23 at Williston here. Listen, I'm doing a great Facebook Live and YouTube Live on the secret to perfect landings. You get signed up on YouTube or Facebook. It's totally free. It is September 27th at 8 p.m. Eastern time. Also, I'm giving away a Bose headset all this month, all of September. Go to m08.com/Bose, and you get signed up. Links to both those, links to the live stream and links to the Bose giveaway are in the description and in this video below here. Enjoy the rest of your day, and most importantly, remember, a good pilot is always learn. Have a great day, guys. We'll see ya.
I sincerely hope you loved watching this video. These videos you see online are simply just the tip of the iceberg of what we do here at M0A.com. M0A is a complete private instrument, commercial, and FOI online ground school. Everything is done at your own pace online. You watch our lessons, also online, take practice exams, all from any device. If you love these free videos we put out here on YouTube and Facebook, I encourage you to check out our complete online ground school for the knowledge test, check ride, and most importantly, setting you up to make you that safe real-world pilot. Take a 2-week free trial, no strings attached, of our online ground school by visiting mzeroa.com/trial.